Welcome back, folks. It is Blazing Gamer here, and we're continuing our journey here on Train Simulator World, right where we left off. Ain't too much going on here. What I would like to do at this time is welcome all of our new subscribers that are on the channel. And just say thanks for subscribing, really. Not just too exactly sure where I left off conversation-wise. Uh-oh. Oh, well. I didn't see that signal coming up. I don't know. I had to leave, and I come back to finish our recording here, and it looks like it stopped raining. Speed up here a little bit. The speed limit's probably looking like 30 or 35. And we're going up almost a 1% grade. It's gonna hit 1% here in a little bit. So the more juice I can give her now, the better. It's foggy out. Oof. Wish it was still raining. Takes away some of the fun, but oh well. It's foggy like it was raining, but it ain't raining. Yep, now we're up to 1.2% grade. Grade's starting to drop off here a bit here. Some nice houses here. I just missed a chance for doing a screenshot there. Some nice houses. And it's fog though. I thought he was gonna jump out in front of us here. All Oh, that. I love that. Just the realism with the flashing lights, the hoses dangling in the wind. This game is so nice. Just look at that. Hey, how's it going? Howdy. Cruising with the window down. Howdy, ma'am. Can't turn the break though. That's it. That's it. I'll close the door. And the scene, just the scenery in this game. Next thing, I would love to do this one on like a clear day. Do this run with all these coal cars. Mile long coal car train on a nice clear day on this route. There's still a lot of nice scenery that I wish you could see. Yeah, this game, it's actually raining right now, but it's pretty hard to tell. Guarantee we're gonna have a red signal. That signal just switched to red. But I think here, if we switch back into in-cab view, we're gonna have a... It's still another mile. The smoke ain't working. That's what this game, like I said, this game has some glitches. Now, I didn't shut the game down until I didn't have any sound when I started it back up. I paused it and just kind of tabbed out and left. I'm gonna know how train drivers actually know when like the honk blow the horn because the crossing is coming up. Yeah, I mean it's raining right now, but it's not raining. I love how there's like no sound difference right now. Whether I'm outside the train or inside the train. Oh, maybe that's why. I'm just gonna, not really able to signal 2 miles. Let's see if we can run it at 35 here. They're still going up a 1% grade. And we're still pulling up the frickin' rest of the train probably at the 1.2% grade. Well, we're hitting the checkpoint now, guys. Well, we still got a yellow signal yet, so I'll put the power back on. Yeah, I wish there's a radio something in here, but I'd probably get copyrighted for listening to the radio. I should probably give her more power. Crank the power to her, boys. Get her done. I think I was on the ball kind of commentary, keeping y'all entertained a little bit, but now it's late at night and not too quite sure what all you want to talk about. The only thing I don't like about this, like, usually, like, you have little cowboys here. You know, a cute little cowboy. You know, but at night, it's really, really bright. And you got this little, you know, you got a little desk light here. The light's up there, and this one, like, here, if you sit down here, you see how bright it is, and it's daytime. You can just do it like this, you can dim it down, so it's a nice, dull... I don't know why that's showing me a yellow signal. If I remember this correctly, I have a red signal coming up. Or you just crank it all the way up. That thing is bright. And yeah, the same too on this side, but if you come down here, I couldn't figure out how to turn this light on. For the life of me, when you come in this train and it's dark, I mean, this is, it's not like one of those other trains, the other trains in this game. It's not a small little cabin. So, I mean, we have a bathroom here. We got a refrigerator. Well, here's the bathroom with the toilet light. Yeah, you can't get in there, which I wish you could, you know, open the door or whatever. What's that signal say right there? Yeah, two double reds. Does that mean I have to stop? Oh yeah, I have to stop, like, now. Oh boy. I seen that. Why is that signal so small? Did you guys see that? It's like this little tiny red double signal here. Look at that. I really hope. Yeah, I have. Oh boy. Oh my god. Well, folks, that was almost the first crash. Well, that would have sucked. As the brake pressure comes off, we'll start moving back. Yeah, that's the brakes release there. And as I've kind of figured that. So now we have a green signal with another red signal 2 miles. I was not expecting that little signal there. I seen the double reds, and then I seen that little, like, I think a little red signal there, and I'm like, oh boy. So let's get this thing, yeah, all the way back, yeah, release. I'll set the independent brake to like 25% just to hold me. And at this point, I think we're at the top, and I think we're going to start our, like, 15-mile descent. Yep. There's our destination right there. 15 miles left. And trust me, this 15 miles seems like forever because that's there. But we have to go around the whole map. And it'll basically, that's what it seems like. And then to get there. So that stays at 15 for quite a while. Alright. So brakes are released. Start putting on the power. Hold that down to bail off to get rid of all my brake pressure. Those are all released. Forward. Yep. Throw that on. As the sand, as we start inching forward a little bit and getting the sand actually underneath them wheels, the pull. Oh yeah. Oh, we were going down grade, I guess, because I was backing up. Now we're gonna go up a 5% grade. That sander stopped. Lead axle sand. Come on, baby. Oh, excuse me. I came out of nowhere. Alright, so we're picking up speed. I could shut the sanders off now. If I'm correct, we gotta go through a tunnel here. Are we switching tracks back over here? Because I remember that like thing that we passed back there. Nope. Yep. Alright, so I can't even see that other track. Oh yeah, I had to back out of this tunnel here coming up. So let me just set this camera back here. And a good thing I wasn't doing over 20 miles an hour because I would have never stopped. But when you're in the middle of a freaking long tunnel and you start seeing headlights in the same track you're on, you tend to stop pretty quick. Let's say hi to these workers here. And cut back our power at the same time. And we're going down a slight grade here. Look at this. Gotta get my screenshots in sometime. See how the screen's fucking up? Or screwing up, my bad. Now me, I just want to haul butt down this tunnel, but we have a red signal coming up. Yeah, let's make it a little exciting, huh? Now, if for anybody that's here for realism, I try to keep real, you know, to my best ability for realism. But I mean, you got it's me. I like to have a little bit of fun here now and then, so don't gripe on me too hard. You don't think it'd be too foggy in this tunnel, but oh boy, that red signal's coming up quick. And we have a lot of speed to kill. Oh boy. I'm throwing an emergency now. Well, folks, we're restarting. Because I can't even stop right now. Like, I don't know what's going on. I mean, my brakes are in full emergency, and it's taken all this work. Was that signal not meant to be red? That I just blew through? Because I think I'm supposed to be on that track. I mean, this train was in full emergency, full independent brakes, and it took... What was up with that? Full emergency and we're just cruising at freaking 40 some miles an hour. Another thing you could do, you could fold that in. Leave it flat, angle it in, so the rain runs off of it. Alright. And you see, we're on a pretty steep downgrade. My train's rolling and I haven't even given it throttle yet. I'm still in setup. But at this point, we're going to start giving a power to her here. Probably help if I took the emergency off, right? That right there never seems like it does anything for emergency anyway. It's on 2%, that's all we have. Okay, I'm not doing that, but I'll bet you $100 that my mouse isn't moving right now. I don't know why this game does that. Actually, that's a little bit normal. You know? You know, you're gonna have vibrations and stuff, but I mean, it's a train, you shouldn't have that much vibration. See, if you're going in a car down the road, or doing what we're about to do after we hit this 2 miles here. I'm gonna put this thing in the setup and let it sit idle for a minute. It says not to do it unless you're for 10 minutes, but Greenstone's playing spin tires. Well, you'll have fun on some spin tires. We gotta do some more spin tire recording, folks. That red light's still showing 2 miles, but wait, the speed limit's still 25. Alright. So that's in brake position 1. Oh, they updated it, so instead of the amp meter going up, it's actually going to the negatives. Oh, that's sweet. Before, when you used to use the dynamic braking, the amp meter still used to go positive. It'd say negative on, like, here. It'd say like a negative amperage right there, but like it would just say like positive amps. As you see, we're gaining a lot of speed down this hill. And I'm dynamic braked right now. Not as much as I can be. I can go more. I can go a lot more actually, but... And you see, that's only at 6, and I maxed the meter out. So I think at this point, put put it back to idle. Let her rip. Because I don't think that red signal is right. I guess we'll find out if I'm doing this again here shortly, because I decided to, oh boy, those signals are red. And there's no way I'm stopping this thing before the red, whatever is coming this way. I wonder if this game like sped up time, because I mean, it's like this point in time where this game is pouring rain, and it's not. You see, we're pulling 0 amps in the motors, because... Alright, now that's where I start getting worried, because this is getting squirrely. I'm gonna turn these wipers off, because it's, like, getting nice and sunny out. Yeah, I'll know when to stop once it really starts getting squirrely, but... I'll let it sit idle, and I'll let it sit and set up. And I'll just open that up and get that ready in case I gotta throw an emergency to get this thing to slow down. I mean, we're now almost a 2% grade here. We didn't even go up this steep of a grade. Now it's about 1.4% here. This red light's coming up awful quick too. Sure is a shame that this train wasn't to stop. Oh, I'll do what anybody else would do. I wonder if these signals are right because I'm on the wrong line. I think I am. I think I'm supposed to be on this line and it didn't switch because I didn't actually stop there. Oh my god! We are doing 106 miles an hour, folks. I did not even realize this. Oh, 107. I want, if we get this to 110 out... I want everybody who watches this video to subscribe. Oh yeah, folks, that is it. I gotta get a screenshot of that. This is freaking ridiculous, folks. And I'm at idle. I'm actually in setup, so I'm applying no power. You know it'd be funny if I threw that in reverse and gave her gas. Oh, I think this is the bend I was on last time. Oh my god, we're at 116. High speed freight, boys. It's the next generation new thing. They thought high speed people transportation was... Oh! Yeah. She was squirrely, folks. She was really squirrely. Well, we'll reload from last checkpoint and see if they... actually updated the game. Nope. It crashed. Well, folks, that is all for this time. Be sure to go show Gearjammer some love and support on his channel.